Hi guys! Today's video is going to be shocking, so you might want to take a minute to make sure you're sitting down. Okay, are you ready? Right then. So, British Brits were tagged to do the Yellow Book tag by Dawn, aka Bookaholic DK, and I volunteered to do it, which is alarming in of itself, because I am, as you know, the Queen of Purple, and so I wouldn't have that many yellow books. So actually, I thought this was going to be an easy video because I only thought I'd have about five yellow books. It'd be over quickly, and we could move on with our lives. But actually, I have quite a lot of yellow books, and it makes me think of my former self. Maybe she's secretly lurking underneath and making me acquire all these yellow books. Because you see, there was actually a time when I did not know that purple was the best colour that ever existed and ever will exist in the universe. I know, it's shocking, but there was a time when I was, 11 or younger, when my favourite colour was actually yellow. I know. I'm alarmed too. Every time I remember this, I'm shocked. Really, I am. Because it doesn't make any sense. Purple is obviously the best. I don't know what I was thinking. But anyway, on with the yellow book tag. Book number one is the Annotated Classic Fairy Tales. I haven't read this yet, and I can't wait. It's a book that is in my list of shame, and so I have vowed to try my best to read it this year. Next up, Baby Names for Dummies. Of course, all Dummies books are this very bright shade of yellow. I've had this for quite a few years now, and a while back my mum saw it on my shelf and was like, "What the hell is going on? Why do you have a baby names book? That's weird." And then I was like, "I'm a writer? It's totally normal for me to have baby name books." Plus, I'm just generally obsessed with names. I love it. Naming characters is almost one of the best bits of writing. Haunting of Sunshine Girl. This is a proof, so I don't know if the final version will actually have any yellow on the cover. Ditto with Valentine Joe. This copy of I'll Give You the Sun is a proof, but I know that the cover is the same gorgeous design, and I can't wait to read this. Every time I remember that I have this, but I haven't read it yet, I'm just appalled at myself. Sienna. Bit more yellow on the back, but it's a pretty nice, pretty light shade of yellow. It's probably the only shade of yellow that I would consider wearing. The Blind Assassin by Margaret Atwood. Also, this nice pale shade of yellow. Ghost Flower. Haven't read this, but really want to. It's got some very pretty gold foiling on it as well. Look. Ooh. Waterstones Guides to Kids Books. This may look like a catalogue to you, but I will have you know that they made people pay £3 or show their Waterstones card for it. And it has an ISBN. Yeah. This is actually really good. This came out in 2008, 2009, and I got it while I was working at Waterstones, and it was really useful to get to know what the current and most popular and classic kids books were, and I found absolutely loads of books to read through reading this. Don't know if they still do them, but they should because it's great. These couple of books are a bit weird. The Writer's Handbook 2006, which I should probably recycle soon because it's really out of date, almost 10 years. Laughing Out Loud, Writing the Comedy-Centered Screenplay. I don't actually have that much interest in writing comedy-centered screenplays, but when I saw this in a charity shop, I thought I'd get it, just in case. Why not? Weirdly specific writing books for the win. The Wind's 12 Quarters by Ursula Le Guin. Roald Dahl's Revolting Rhymes, which is a book I love and cherish. I have really good memories of going to see my nan when she was in hospital when I was a kid and reading her the poems from this book to cheer her up. Rena, which is my favourite in the Fashionista series by Sarah Manning. She's just so grumpy, it's fantastic. Duff, which I should read soon as the movie has come out or is coming out soon. 8 Hours, which is a short story collection, and this more yellow towards the bottom. This is only a little bit yellow, it's mostly orange and red, but Emily and the Hollow World. The Demon's Watch, which is mostly yellow on the back, it's this nice pale yellow again. Mrs. Pepperpot to the Rescue, which is a book I read over and over when I was a kid. I think I also had an anthology of Mrs. Pepperpot books as well. This one has really pretty illustrations on it, and they carry on the inside as well. This is one that kind of moves from yellow to orange and brown, The Unknown Errors of Our Lives. Harriet the Spy is yellow and purple, so it kind of combines my past and former lives, and probably when I read this, yellow was still my favourite colour, so maybe this was the turning point, who knows. Even though yellow is purple's complementary colour, its opposite, really makes it pop, I don't wear it. The colour combination is a bit UKIP, and also I'd have to wear yellow, and I don't think yellow suits me, even in conjunction with purple. Empress of the World by Sarah Ryan. The Accidental by Ellie Smith, which is kind of a browny yellow. Saving June. Nice pale yellow, but definitely yellow. Twisted, the fourth book in the Fearless series by Francine Pascal. I was obsessed with this series when I was a teenager, but I never finished it, and I'll tell you why. It was because when I was a teenager, it was back in the days when books cost the amount they said on the cover. And how much does it say on this tiny little volume? £4.99. Oh yes, that's £5 for this title volume. And I used to get £1 pocket money a week. So, I was not going to buy all of those. I got some from the library, but they didn't have them all, and so I still hold out the hope that one day I will actually read all of the Fearless books. Hex and the Single Girl. The Outsiders, classic YA title that I have not read. The Yellow Wallpaper and Other Stories. I've read The Yellow Wallpaper, but I haven't read the other stories. The Unabridged Pocketbook of Lightning. Wake. This is gorgeous, this cover. Brown and yellow on black, beautiful. Povidky, short stories by Czech women. There is a short story in this set at a school with a bunch of teenage girls that I really love. Remix by Norman Pratt. This is fab. Pre-order it now. And the final cover does have yellow in it. Woo! The Child That Books Built, same kind of yellow as I'll Give You the Sun. And the next two last books have blue and yellow on them. Mrs. P's Journey is mostly blue, but it has a nice yellow spine. And Weirdos vs. Bumskulls is about half and half. Got some yellow people, some blue people, and then some splashes of blue and yellow on the back. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and you are probably still reeling from the shocking reveal that purple hasn't always been my favourite colour. I hope that didn't mar your enjoyment of this video completely. So please do like this video and subscribe to Bookish Brits if you want to see more from me and the others. And I haven't conferred with the Bookish Brits about who we should tag, so I'm going to tag in the comments or the description. You'll see me in a couple of weeks. Bye!